symptomatology, and what we are going to talk today is the acute abdomen. Appendicitis forms a part of an acute abdomen. An acute abdomen is a situation where a person develops sudden onset of pain in the abdomen, which could be due to various reasons, appendicitis being one of the reasons giving rise to an acute abdominal pain. Now earlier, way back, an acute abdomen used to be treated with fright, because then there were not many advances whereby you could peep into the abdomen and see what is happening and what needs to be corrected. So earlier people had progress, you know, trying to remove the pus from the chest and certain other things, but in the abdomen not many people ventured. But because of the development of the anesthesia analgesics, now it is becoming possible for us to open the abdomen and see what is happening. So that is what it is. A patient with an acute abdomen will present with sudden onset of pain. It could be very severe, and it could be because of various reasons. If we look at the abdomen could be, the as you see it, can be divided into 3, 3, 6 and 3, 9 quadrants. At the level of the umbilicus, this is the umbilical region. This would be the right hypochondrium. The epigastric region, the left hypochondrium. This would be the right lumbar region, umbilical region, left lumbar region, right iliac fossa, hypogastric region, and the left iliac fossa. Now the patient would present with pain in any of these quadrants. That is because of the stimulation of a covering which is known as the peritoneum. The peritoneum gets involved because of peritonitis, and that is how it manifests. Now if you see, this is the epigastrium, where more so the stomach is situated. In the right hypochondrium you have the liver and the gallbladder. Left hypochondrium you have the spleen, and this is anteriorly. Posteriorly you have the kidneys in the right hypochondrium, right lumbar region, left kidney in the left hypochondrium and the lumbar region. In the right iliac fossa you have the appendix. In the hypogastrium, in the females, you have the uterus, the ovaries, and in the left you have the large bowel. The large bowel also extends around. Now, how, depending upon the organ that gets involved, a patient will present with severe abdominal pain in the region where the organ is. If a patient has severe ulcer problems, he will present with pain in the epigastric region. If he has a problem with the pancreas, again he will present with severe pain in the epigastric region. and radiating to the back, because the pancreas is a structure which is situated retroperitoneally, that is behind the stomach. In the right hypochondrium, the patient, if at all he has a liver abscess, he will present with pain in the right hypochondrium associated with pain in the in between the lower ribs. Just below the liver we have the gallbladder. An inflammation of the gallbladder can give rise to severe colicky pain in the right hypochondrium. Severe colicky pain in the right hypochondrium. Similarly, if the patient has got appendicitis, he will initially get pain around the umbilicus and later on it will settle in the right iliac fossa. A pain in the left side of the abdomen indicates that there is a colonic involvement, that is involvement of the large bowel. Okay, now next. Now one of the investigations that one needs to do is an X-ray. Associated along with that is the hematological investigations that we carry on. The basic hematological investigation that one carries out is the hemogram, which involves the hemoglobin, CBC. CBC indicates the amount of infection which may be associated with that abdominal problem. And urine examination to rule out any type of urinary tract infection. Okay. Now, how does a patient present with an acute abdomen? He will start with severe amount of pain, especially when there is a perforation of an ulcer of the duodenum. The patient will be able to tell you that at a particular time he develops sudden onset of pain because there is a perforation and all the toxic chemicals get liberated into the abdominal cavity and the patient will have severe abdominal pain. Similarly, in the case of a urinary colic, the patient will get severe pain, excruciating pain, and it may be associated with vomiting as well. A patient with appendicitis, an acute attack, will also be able to tell you the exact moment when he has developed a sort of a throbbing pain over there. Similarly, in the females, you have the ovaries. A twisted ovarian cyst will also be, the patient will also be able to tell you about the onset of the pain, the exact moment when the pain has developed. In the males again, a torsion of the testis, the patient will be able to tell you the exact moment. In cases of chronic abdominal pain, they will be able to tell you a history that it has happened a couple of months earlier, a couple of days earlier. But in the acute abdomen, the patient will be able to tell you the exact moment when the pain has initiated. Secondly, the pain may also be associated with vomiting. The patient may vomit. The patient may vomit out of a reflex action, that is, because of the severe pain, he will develop nausea and he will vomit. But in case there is a severe obstruction in the case of the small bowel, then there will be a copious amount of vomiting which the patient will experience. In other situations, the vomiting will not be as much. In large bowel obstruction, the vomiting onset is much later than in the small bowel obstruction. Because of the sudden onset of pain, the patient can go into a syncopal attack. But gradually, if put to rest, he will definitely recover. If at all there is a hemorrhage because of trauma or because of a burst in one of the vessels intra-abdominally, the patient can have a fainting attack, may collapse, and even go into a state of shock. This can occur whenever there is a trauma to structures such as the spleen or an abdominal aortic aneurysm. If it bursts, that can give rise to sudden. And in the females, if it's an ectopic type of pregnancy which burst, that can also give rise to a sudden hemorrhage in the abdominal cavity, giving rise to a hypovolemic shock, that is a shock because of low blood volume. The third in the history is the bowel function. Because of these episodes, the bowel gets a little dormant, and therefore the bowel action is reduced. That is so in cases of the small bowel. But if there is an obstruction, then initially there will be a hyper movement of the bowel, and later on it would subside. Now, important is in the physical examination of the patient. The patient will be in severe pain. If it's a colicky pain because of a ureteric calculus or pancreatitis or gallbladder colic, the patient will be unable to bear the pain and he will be writhing. Whereas if it's a duodenal ulcer perforation, and if it is pancreatitis, then the patient will not be able to move and he will prefer to be in a supine rest position. Besides the hemogram, we also depend a lot on the X-ray films. This is a normal X-ray of the abdomen. This is the diaphragm on either side.